Please support us by sharing this message so that it can get to the UN, the ECOWAS, and to the African people. First of all, let me congratulate and thank the Malian military and the people of Mali for using a diplomatic way to handle the problem we have in Mali. May Allah, God Almighty, and the spirit of our forefathers bless you, guide you, and protect you all. This is how we want all African people, countries, cities, villages to come together, no matter their tribe, language, color. Let them come together and wipe out all these tears, bloodshed, hunger, poverty, diseases, illiteracy, war, crisis, exile that are befalling on African people. African people and their military have to come together as one to discuss the issue they have in their countries and to agree in one voice. The rest African countries have to learn this wisdom and knowledge from the Malian soldiers. They have to know that they are fighting and killing themselves and their children. African soldiers have to listen to the voice of their people and save their land from bloodshed and destruction. The leaders have to also listen to the voice of the people, whether old or young, because they are there to lead, save and guide the people of the land, not killing them or causing them pains and tears. The Cameroonian military and the Ambazonian soldiers should please stop the killings. We can't bear it anymore, watching you kill our people continually. The president of Cameroon, Paul Biya, and the people of Cameroon, English or French, please, you all have to come together and find a solution to all these disagreements, war and bloodshed in Cameroon. We are still begging the president of Ivory Coast, Alassane Ouattara, that he should please listen to the voice of his people and stop anything that could bring disagreements and war in Ivory Coast. If the people said they want another person to lead them, at least listen to them and give them the chance. You have ruled for 8 years. I mean, we are talking of a country and its people here. So please let the Ivorians choose their next leader. We don't need any war anymore in Ivory Coast or anywhere in this world. The Ivorians have suffered enough. War and crisis have killed and sent many Ivorians to exile. So please stop. We don't need any more bloodshed in our land. The president of Guinea, Alpha Condé, please hear the voice of your people. Presidency is not a private or a family business. Stop anything that could cause disputes and war in your country, Guinea. What else did you need 13 for? If the people said they have heard enough of you, please be wise. The tears and pains in Africa is too much. Let me ask the UN and the ECOWAS, what is your problem in Mali happiness? Why is the CEDEAO, that is the ECOWAS, and the UN not happy with Mali people and their soldiers? What did the Mali people did to deserve all these sanctions and accusations? Is it wrong for the military to stand by their people and decide together on how to protect their land? Is it the UN or the ECOWAS that will decide what will happen in Mali? The president himself is from Mali. The militaries are from Mali. The peoples are Malians. They all have agreed together, and the president resigned peacefully, offering a peaceful speech to his people. So what the hell is your problem, ECOWAS and the UN? Stop threatening Mali and its people, because all your plans to cause another war in Mali have failed. Where were you when Mali needed you most? For so many years, ECOWAS have not used their power to stop the war in Mali. Up to now, the jihadists are still fighting and killing Mali people. Poverty, hunger, crisis, war have taken over Mali. While Mali was one of the richest countries in the world, gold, diamonds, silver, wood, precious stones filled up the whole land, but still no hope for the future. 60% of Malians are out of school or never attended school for once. Millions of lives are being lost in the hospital because no proper care. Our people are technically being sent to exile because of the hardship in the country. Many souls are being lost in the desert and the Mediterranean Sea. Africans are now sending themselves to slavery because of the dangers in their countries. Is this what the UN and the ECOWAS want for us in Africa or in Mali? Boko Haram have been bombing and killing people in Nigeria. Muslims, Christians, pagans are being killed. What have the ECOWAS and the UN done about it for so many years? I have told you, stop your threats to Mali and take them to Boko Haram and the jihadists. Fulani people are there killing and sending people out of their land in Nigeria.
You never find any solution to that. Is it the people that stand together to defend and free their land you want to sanction? Be very careful. UN and ECOWAS never try to send your military to Mali because nobody invites you. The people of Mali and the military will always defend their land. Nigerians should come together. Hausas, Igbos, and Yorubas should voice together to free their land from bloodshed. They should stop the injustice in the leadership that is preventing the eastern region to rule. Former President Goodluck Jonathan should please stop being a messenger for the ECOWAS. We all know that you are a peacemaker, but message under the ECOWAS is useless because they are not making anything better for the West African states. Nigerian military should stop fighting for their president and fight for their people. African soldiers are dying in war because of lack of care and equipment. Please, soldiers should remember that those that they are killing are their children, mother, fathers, brothers, sisters, uncles, aunties, friends, classmates. Soldiers are not stick or iron. They are humans like us. How can we be sending them to kill themselves? In Europe, America, or elsewhere, soldiers are enjoying watching the streets, marketplaces, gatherings, presidential areas, not dying in the bush with hunger and bombs. How can we come together and fight for our independence and later start killing each other? Please let us all use this type of tactics to gain the victory we want in Africa. Congo, please solve the issues between you and your brothers. You have suffered enough from the hands of the colonialism of criminality. Please stop the bloodshed and the pains in your country. Come together and take a decision that will favor everyone in your land. African nations must stand. The UN and the ECOWAS, we are giving you people the last warning to withdraw all your threats and your sanctions over Mali. You should let the Mali people breathe. Let them to enjoy their freedom because the people have spoken and the military have come together with them to take a decision that will favor their land. So please, don't add anything to it. Only what you will do is to support them, is to congratulate them, is to help them to find a good president that can lead the country forward, a good person that will make Mali to be great again. So please, stop all these sanctions because it's not going to take you anywhere. Everybody have freedom of speech. All countries have freedom and they have their own laws and their decisions to make by themselves. It is not the UN nor the ECOWAS that have to take a decision on what will happen in Mali. There is no right. You are fighting for just the president. The president is not telling you that he is bad. He's not telling you that he will not resign. He has resigned peacefully. He has spoken to his people peacefully. So what else? Why are you still drawing war close to Mali? Why are you still beating the drum of war? Stop all this nonsense and support the people of Mali to grow. Support African people to gain their freedoms. Please, I beg you, all the military in the whole African country, in the whole African land, that you should learn this lesson. Learn this wisdom and knowledge from these Mali people. Learn it from them and come together as one. Because you are the ones that are dying. Those people, they didn't care about you. The people that are giving you laws, the people that are telling you what to do, they are not care about you. They didn't care anything about you. Because when you are in their country, they are still treating you like slaves. I can see why the whites are even calling the black people monkeys. I can see why they are insulting them that they are not literate, they are not educated. Because it is the African people that are allowing them to give them decisions. They are allowing them to take a word in their path. They are allowing them to tell them what to do in their country and in their constitution. And it's very, very bad. Because they will see you as a senseless people. That is what is going on. That is how they have misled all our leaders. They have poisoned all their brains. That our leaders never think of their people. They never think of their citizens. They only think of themselves. You can imagine a continent like Africa that if anything happened to any African person around the world, nobody is going to rescue that person. All countries will go and rescue their people, but African countries will abandon. They will abandon and leave their people to die and suffer in another country, no matter the condition, even when they are at the point of death. They will leave them there to die there. It is very, very bad. All these bad constitutions and bad world, bad laws have to change. We have to change it because we are the ones that are dying. We may not agree for you presidents being on the seat and allowing our people to die on exile. We will not agree to let you see our people suffer, cry to you, and see you will abandon them there. So what is about your presidency? Who are you ruling? If you cannot take care of the people, who are you ruling? That is why many African leaders have to leave that presidency. They have to leave that seat. They have to look for somebody tangible, somebody that has the fear of God to lead African people through this stress and distress. It is so, so bad. And we have to stop it there. Let us not take a decision from anybody. We have our life to live. We have the right to talk of our life. We have the right to talk of how we feel, and we have the right to talk of what we want and what we need in our land. So let no decision come from anywhere, not even the US. Let them take their decision to the terrorists, the people killing Mali people, the people causing war in Africa. Let them take their decisions to them, the Boko Haram and the jihadists or the ISIS. Let them go and fight them and leave the Mali soldiers and the Malian people alone. Let them leave them alone to enjoy their freedom. I am congratulating you Malian people so, so much. I am so glad to see that you achieved this victory without tears, without any bloodshed, without even one person dying. God will always continue to bless you all. And never you all forget that even the time of colonization, the Mali people was even one of the first African countries to take independence. So that country, freedom is from Mali. And I am so happy. And I am very, very happy to see you all survive and succeed. Please, the militaries and the people of Mali should please be wise. They should please open their eyes. Let them not be deceived to choose another bad person to be in presidency. Let them not be deceived to choose the person that doesn't have the fear of God into the presidency. Let them choose person that is good, that have the fear of God. Person that know what it meant to suffer. Person that have passed through all sorts of distress in this world. That know what it feels for someone to sleep without food. Let them take that kind of person to the presidency so that African people will survive. Because those that are there, some of them don't even care of the poor people. When they see the poor people, they will just drive off. They will not even look at their face. All what they think in their mind that those people, they are lazy. They don't want to work. That is only what they think. They don't know the situation. They don't know the condition. They don't know how you are in that your position. They don't even care to help. So those bad leaders have to come down. They have to submit to the African people because this is the time of our freedom and liberty. This is the time for us to say no. We are the one that we take our decisions and not people to take our decisions for us.
International Nyabala, Union Européenne Nyabala, CEDAO Nyabala, Moshima Kumakana, président fait, il a pour vous la main. Aïto, qu'on a la tram ou fragment fitation ou la moumoua en Sava. Et comme vous voyez, ma quête, cadeau banan, moum banan à la samou kéné. Donc, ambo, qu'on a fait, bernou tour à la vulitourbi, anga jamana yere mila lelo tuyi soufi flo. President denge yere kelembe kibinere jamana kon. Gouvernement de silence qui reflète, fait de l'eau à main jamana, à main à fil du chimbawa. Donc, je suis en train de me dire que les Européens, l'Union Européenne, les CEDAO, l'Union Soumise, a bégué ce problème là. Ou qui ce problème là, a été fait pour que ce soit à tsara foku o dat sera do ap mako mais nous dans le document ngono o ki jida mimani ben jamana ko na mako gole la quoi mais o kona ire ka foku bogar ke ta saka nula kana ni ko sa son vrai mali ko no mena ni gela vrai de mali ko no san jogo ri san wolum fla e anga ko fela be tukuma a sera jamana europe ma gela be mali ko no mali ndew de ba do quoi donc o ambe kuma min fola wi a kana me quoi sinon na ko ko abe fempete Fenfen kana malien ma malien dem anyaba la quoi donc amen mi fawi ay sabali na ma sabali au habit de mima ta foko soufasi mbé et population a mouflé fobe président ka intérêt le djadimina ana wire ka intérêt ay sabali en fonay hada ma demnde ante perawere ante kumo no fewye en quoi ma ko bangire de la amba ga indépendance totalita amma sem ko shikana mbulu daga bu jamana wure kha donc ambe kuma mi fawi abi sem manga kula wodi do ala sago aw sago anga na kuma bana yango
Aouya Mewa, Wadedo. Voilà, c'est comme ça. Foytala, nous tous on est là avec les Maliens.